Many artists have asked me what's the best size 00 brush. Well, if you've watched any of my videos, you'll know that I like to use a Winsor Newton Cotman Series 111. Now, one of the things that attracts me to the size 00 brush, this particular one anyway, is the fact that, one, it's not expensive. But because I work with thousands of brush strokes, I know that probably one brush will last me maybe a couple of paintings, two or three paintings. But the beauty about that, it's not cost me a fortune. So when you consider the price of the brush compared to the amount of work you've done within a painting, it's not bad going. But even so, I never throw that brush away because it still comes in handy for special effects as well. So once that tip wears away, save that brush. Don't throw it in the bin, okay? Keep hold of it. The other reason why I like this brush is because it's synthetic. It's not sable or anything like that. But because it's not natural hairs, I find with this particular brush is that I've got more control over it. I can really push them bristles around and they always reform back to a point afterwards, before that point wears away, of course. But remember, that's only because I use thousands of brush strokes within each individual painting I do. And you can see that from the work I'm showing you here. But can you imagine if I bought one of the more expensive brushes out there? You know very well how expensive some of the brushes can get. And then that brush only lasts me for two or three paintings. I would not be very happy with that, would I? So it goes to show that you don't always have to worry too much about buying expensive brushes. Especially if you're a beginner with watercolours and you're starting to put all your materials together and you're obviously considering the price at the same time. But there's always a but. Don't try and economise too much on the paint and the paper. With those items, you need to think about buying something more of a mid-range quality. Now, one thing I do like to consider with a brush is the snap rate. So how well does it kind of reform back to its tip? So when you pull that brush away from the paper, does it go back to a point again straight away? Or spring back rate? Think about it that way around instead. So does it spring back into shape? Or does it simply stay in a bit of a curled form? So remember, with synthetic bristles, very often they snap back to the point on the shape they originally were when you first bought the brush. Now, another thing I like to consider as well is how well you can hold that brush. Some brushes, as we know, got extremely long handles. And when the handles are really long, I tend to find that sometimes you've got the wrong balance in your hand. So you really want to be able to control that brush. And when you're working with a fine size 00 brush like I do, then therefore you want to make sure you've got as much control as possible. So I find by having a shorter handle on a brush, I find it much easier to hold that way around as well. Now also, this brush is very thin. And because it's quite thin, it doesn't feel like you've got much weight in your hand either. Sometimes I find I get a cramp in my hand when I'm holding a thicker handled brush. So having a nice slim brush in my hand just gives me better control when I'm using that brush. So when you buy a brush, consider the weight, consider the length of the brush, and also the thickness. Remember, if you're working with detail, you'll be holding that brush for a very long time. And even though I've mentioned that, yes, the tip wears away after a while, which it can do, for thousands of brush strokes, this will maintain a very decent point. And that's so, so important when you're working with detail. The finer the point that you've got, the finer the lines you can create. But then again, that obviously depends on how much paint that you put on that paintbrush. So a round brush with a short handle. Now this is quite a traditional popular head shape as well for all-purpose watercolour work. Obviously we can get flat brushes as well, we know that, or chiselled edge brushes if you wish. But the good thing about these round brushes is that they can be used for broad strokes as well. So you start off with a fine tip by barely putting pressure onto the paper, increase that pressure to get a broader stroke as you pull away. As you pull your brush down, increase the pressure to get a wider, thicker stroke. Then gradually come off that pressure as you pull away from the paper as well. By doing so, you get a nice varied stroke of paint on that paper. But that goes to show how versatile these brushes can be, even when it's a small size 00 brush like this one. You know, I'm also surprised as well with a synthetic brush is how well they hold the paint. So the colour holding capacity, the sensitivity, the spring, and of course the durability of this particular brush. And I can use this brush for many different techniques, such as scumbling, where I can use a brush in a more random fashion where the brush is slightly on its side, but not overloaded with paint though. And this will give you a nice kind of broken effect by scumbling on the paper. And I very often do this as well with a shaky hand. You know, then there's stippling. Now, stippling is something I do on a regular basis, create lots and lots of fine details and points. And because this brush has got a very fine point on the top of it, I can create lots and lots of tiny dots on the paper where I can increase the density of these dots to make the area darker or decrease the amount of dots I use to give a nice lighter effect. So stippling is a really good technique when you're working with such a tiny, tiny brush like this one. Dry brush. Now, dry brush technique is really useful for creating texture on the paper. So as long as I don't put too much paint on this brush, I can then use it just to very lightly drag over the surface of the paper by holding the brush nearly on its side, and by doing that you can create all sorts of effects as well. So we'll skip across a medium textured paper, something like cold press, or watercolour rough paper is even better for that. Another technique I use using this brush is lifting off. Now lifting off is a process where you can remove the paint on the paper to reveal the white of the paper underneath. Now that obviously depends on the staining properties of the colours that you use, because some watercolours do stain. But very often you could just gently lift off the paint without damaging that watercolour surface. Just don't scrub too hard, because you've also got to consider the wear and tear on that very tip of the brush as well. The more lifting off you do with a small brush, the more likely the tip will get worn away. So very often I'll go back to one of my old brushes, the ones that I do not throw in the bin as I mentioned earlier, and use those for the lifting off technique. But this technique can be used for a variety of different things, it really can, for even creating more details. So you can use it for removing mistakes and also creating details over the top, but working in a more negative way, of course. Now, as you may know, I like fine detail, no surprise there then. But this brush is perfect for building up all those individual layers of fine details I like to add to my wildlife paintings. And these are just different examples here that you can see on the way I tend to build up the details using this very fine detail brush. And this is achieved by working with numerous layers of thin, fine lines, and sometimes quite shaky ones as well. Now, have you ever flattened a brush? Pardon? Have you ever flattened a round brush? Now, I do this sometimes to create a chiseled edge as well. The chiseled edge will be rounded, but when you look sideways at the brush, it's nice and flat. And this is perfect for creating even more effects on that watercolour surface. Because in a way, you can also use this in sort of a calligraphic style. And also another way of creating very, very fine lines. Now, one of the things that we find with a size 00 brush is that the paint tends not to last that long within it, because there's not much in the way of bristles or a large body within the bristles to be able to hold the paint. So you do need to reload that brush numerous times. However, when you're working on something such as painting whiskers, as you can see from one of the videos I've made for my members on my website, the way that the fine lines work is that with a reasonably loaded brush, not overloaded, you can create quite long lines really in one fluid motion. So I find this brush perfect for creating whiskers and those little tiny hairs within an animal's face. See, also, even though I've got very large hands, I find holding this little tiny brush quite comfortable because it's both slim, it's light, and it's also quite short. Now, these brushes are readily available. You can buy them from most stockists out there. I've found them just about most places. And it's also a brand name. It's a name that a lot of us artists know, Winsor and Newton. So when I buy these brushes, I don't just buy one brush, I probably buy half a dozen at a time. I mean, for example, when that brush arrives in your post, just having one brush in a packet, it's a bit of waste of packaging really in my eyes. So I find it's worth spending that little bit more money so you've got more of these brushes in stock, ready for when I need to use them. A small brush like this is highly versatile. It can be used for painting large areas of fur. Yes, it takes a while to do, of course it does, but it's also very enjoyable at the same time. Or even down to a very tiny eye. But this enables me to really fine tune something such as an eye, and eventually to be able to create more of a lifelike feel to that life that we can see within the eye. Now, what is the finest detail brush that you like to use within your watercolour paintings? Pop in the comments down below. I'd love to hear about which one that you've got. Now, if you'd like to learn more about the other brushes which I'd like to use, check out the video to the top right. I'll see you there.